everyone, it's Evangeline here at eTrailer, and today we'll be taking a look at our Malone Downloader JStyle Kayak here and our Malone Telos XL Lotus Assist device. That's a kit paired together that can be found right here at eTrailer.com. I am the shortest person on the video team here at eTrailer, so whenever we have to put kayaks on roofs, I'm honestly the one who complains the most. I already have a bunch of different tools. I have a stool, I have a Moki doorstep. They're all designed just to help me get onto those roofs and give me a little extra height, but I can't do that when I'm carrying a kayak. So that's why you get a Lotus Assist device just like this. There's a bunch of different Lotus Assist devices for kayak carriers here at eTrailer, but this is the one designed specifically for the Malone Downloader. You can get adapters so that you can use it with other kayak carriers, but this is a great pairing because they're meant for each other. So let's take a look at how they work. The Malone Downloader has this hole right over here at the end of the ramp, and that's designed for the Telos Lotus Assist device because that clips right into it and allows you to mount and dismount your kayak with ease. So you will get this as a kit, meaning you'll get the downloader and the Telos Lotus Assist device together, but you can also use this device with, let's say, two downloaders if you want to get another one. So let's take a closer look at the Lotus Assist device first. One question is, how big of a boat can I get onto this thing? We have a small kayak, so obviously that fit very well, but can I use my really large canoe with this? So let's take some measurements to find out. First thing is this has a weight capacity of 75 pounds, so if you do have a large fishing boat, probably not gonna fit in that weight capacity. Another thing is measurements. So measuring from right where that arm is to the end of this handle, we have it at 11 inches, and this comes up at about 4 inches. So for the very end of your hull, that's gonna have to fit inside that 11 inch gap, and then you have space further out here. So if it is wider than that, if your boat is bigger than that, it's probably most definitely not gonna fit with this Lotus Assist arm. Also, when it comes to that weight or boat capacity, the question is, can you lift it? You're still gonna have to be able to lift it on to the arms itself and then push it up the Lotus Assist arm. So if you are able to lift your boat up part of the way, this still gives you a break as you do so, so you do not have to do it in all one big movement. But if you can't move it up just that little space, this might not be the best fit for you. So your cradles have this foam padding on it, and that's gonna be helpful since it adds a little bit of extra grip to your kayak as you go up, and also will help protect your hull from extra scratches and scuffs. Now I did notice that just after a little bit of use, I did apply too much pressure right over here on this handle and I dented that foam padding. So that's gonna be natural and that will happen over time as you use this kayak carrier Lotus Assist. That is gonna be some wear and tear that you will experience. Next question, what kayak carriers can I use with this? I'm using the Malone Downloader, which is a very popular pairing with our Telos Lotus Assist. They're actually kind of made for each other, but you can also use this Lotus Assist device with other kayak carriers like the Malone Seawing. And if you have these universal adapters, you can also use them with your own brand of kayak carrier. So I have this where the bottom leg is fully extended just to kind of see what is the tallest or longest setting this can be in. So if you have your taller vehicles, maybe you have, let's say, a Yukon or a 4Runner where you need a little extra height, you might need a longer Lotus Assist arm. So measuring from our bottom arm or bottom leg, it's about 27 inches long. And this other pole can be adjusted with these knobs, and that's going to be 36 inches long. Now you have to make sure you still have a good amount of support. These knobs can actually be moved up and down if needed. Now I still think maybe around 10 inches of support is needed. So that would be a total of about 33, 34 inches of length. Now that measurement was the extension you can add to its current height of about 55 inches from where you hook it onto your kayak here. So if you add those up together, you can see how even with your extra tall vehicles, you'll have enough support. So this utilizes a ratcheting mechanism where you have these little notches that help you lift your kayak carrier. So you pull on this knob in order to release it from those ratcheting notches, and you keep it in place so that it goes up automatically. One thing about that is you have to be mindful to go all the way up. If you only go halfway, it will drop down on its own. If you go all the way up though, it will stop. So we talked about these feet during install and how I was able to use it. Another thing I noticed is that we do have a hole on these feet. So if you are in an area, let's say a campground where it's a little bit softer turf, you could even use a stake to hold that down as you carry or mount and dismount your kayak. So the Malone Downloader is AJ style kayak carrier, which allows you to carry your kayak right over there on your side. So compared to saddle style kayak carriers, this gives you a little bit more room on your RAV4 to carry another kayak or other roof rack accessories. Now this has a little special feature, which is that it has a slight ramp at the end. That way, as you lift your kayak up, you can kind of slide it up on the ramp and into your kayak carrier. But if you need a little extra assist, you can also check out the Telos XL Load Assist device that clips right into the downloader and gives you a little extra help getting that up there. So we have our kayak strapped down to our kayak carrier with our included tie down straps. So they're these red straps and they have these metal cam buckles in them. That way you strap them into your kayak carrier. So you get them around the arm over here at the back, go around your kayak carrier, and then in our case, I like to put them around our crossbars and towers just to get that extra kind of like that force as we bring this down and against our kayak carrier. We also get some bow and stern ropes. So these have a metal hook at the end and they go into your hood and into your hatch, or if you have a hitch, which we do on our RAV4, that goes into the hitch and holds down our bow and stern ropes. Please have both your tie down straps as well as your bow and stern ropes on your kayak before you hit the road. Now we are going to take this off so that we can take a closer look at the carrier itself. So just undo those cam buckles. Oh, while we're here, notice how our cam buckles have this nice cloth backing. That's because as you do have them on your kayak, you want to make sure you're not scuffing it up with the metal buckle. Now let's take this all the way off. So we're ready to dismount or lower our kayak. So we have these large knobs over here and you need to pull those in order to disengage the handles. You're gonna have to be very careful with that though, so it doesn't go all the way down with your kayak. So support your kayak with one hand so it doesn't immediately drop down. Pull that lever and drop it down a couple notches and then allow your kayak to drop down right there. So you still have to support half of the kayak's weight, but still a lot easier than lifting it all the way down. So this is the J-style kayak carrier, right and ready in the loading position. So this is how you're gonna load your kayak. Just move this up here and fit it into place. So we have this ramp, and this ramp has this little hole here, which is gonna be where you put your Telos Load Assist device. Then you also have these padded arms right over here on the upper arm. So that's gonna be what's supporting your kayak and just making sure that you don't scuff or scratch it during transport. These are removable since they have hook and loop straps in them. So if after a while, after some wear and tear, if you wanna wash them, you can do so. Right here on top, you have these hard foam pads and they're kind of interesting in design because they have these little cutouts because that's where you put your bolts in order to clamp down your kayak carrier. Holding our kayak carrier in place are these clamps. So these are universal clamps, meaning they can fit around your round, square, arrow, and most factory bars. They have these bolts that come down, they have this plate that goes around your crossbar, and they have these wing nuts that clamp it down. Now, if you do have an arrow bar which has T-track channels, you can also pick up this T-slot integration hardware kit, and this can replace your clamps, and instead of using those clamps, you use your T-channel in your crossbars. Just an extra option for you if you want extra crossbar space, or if you just like that T-track design, it's nice to know you have that option. So with this kayak carrier, you also have a little bit of adjustability when it comes to storing it or making it a bit more compact. So when you have your kayak up on it, you have it in the loading position. But when you take your kayak off and you just want to kind of drive around town without it up, you can move this lever over to this side and just rotate it downwards, just like that, and then tighten it down again with your lever. You may need to rotate the lever to get a tighter or a looser fit. Just make sure it's completely clamped down. So for our RAV4, we'll take some measurements. So we're gonna measure the height that is added to the top of our roof. So from our roof to the top of the kayak here, which is right where that ramp is, it sits at about 9¾ inches. Now, because of the raised rails on our RAV4, we're kind of limited on where we can mount our J-style kayak here. The idea is to have it as far to the end as you can get it, but not on the overhang. So just make sure it's inside the tower and taking some measurements just to kind of see where that ramp sits. It sits about 4 inches away from the end of your rails. So you will still have to reach up a little bit past your RAV4 in order to load your kayak. So my final thoughts about this kit is you can definitely see how the downloader and the Telus XL load assist device really complement each other. They're really designed for each other. Now, are they the easiest way to load up your kayak? Not so much. I've actually had more luck with the Malone channel loader and the Malone C-Wing, but that's a saddle style carrier and it takes up more bar space on your vehicle. If you are limited by bar space, but you're also limited by actual height and strength to get your kayak up onto your roof, this is a really good pairing for you. Now note, if you don't have that much strength or you're not really able to lift much, you might not be as impressed by this just because you still have to carry a lot of that kayak's weight. It just gives you some resting points. You might be interested in, let's say, the Thule Hullivator, which is a lot more pricey, but you get more premium features, or you might even be interested in a kayak trailer. You can find all of those right here at eTrailer, but it's nice to know that this is a full system, and once you get it, you're ready to go. And that was a look here at our Malone Downloader J-Style Kayak Carrier and our Malone Telus XL Load Assist right here at eTrailer. My name is Evangeline, and I hope you enjoyed the journey.